Hello dearies, welcome to Prati's Kitchen. Now as discussed, I'm back with my veg mayonnaise recipe. I had discussed in my previous video of paneer shawarma that I'd come back with a detailed recipe of a quick veg mayonnaise recipe. So here I am. Now this is something so yummy, I swear by. You can store it, you can make it so easily with three main ingredients. Store it, use it for your salads, your bread, your sandwiches and rolls, of course. So why are we waiting? Let's get cooking. Now, as I said, it's made with three main ingredients: milk, oil and vinegar. I'm also taking a little bit of sugar, salt and garlic here. Garlic because I was making shawarma. You may completely avoid if you don't like it. Now here the milk to oil ratio is about 1:2. I have taken about 1/4 cup of chilled milk, 1 teaspoon of sugar and 1/2 teaspoon of salt and 1 garlic in there. And now I will add my olive oil in batches, in 2 batches. First I'm taking 1/4 cup of oil in there and then I will just give it a nice blend so that it's no more liquidy and it just churns out and becomes semi-solid. And after that I will add my rest of the oil to it. So now give it a good churn. A quick churn and then you would see this is the consistency. Now the third or the fourth main ingredient, if you exclude garlic, that is vinegar. Yes, you heard me right. Vinegar is the main ingredient which gives you the consistency, the sour taste as well as a good texture. So now I've added 1 tablespoon of vinegar to it. You may add lemon juice as well if you don't have vinegar. So that's the substitute. Give it a good churn and make it to this consistency first. Now add your second batch of the 1/4 remaining cup of oil to it. You may use any vegetable oil also if you do not have olive oil. Give it a good mix and after the first churn, you see this is the consistency you would get. But I usually keep a little thicker. Even if you bring it to this consistency and stop it, it is well and good because this, once stored into the refrigerator, will become a little solidified. So now I'm giving another mix, another good churn. And this is exactly the consistency I'm looking for. So now this is what would give me a good spread on my chapatis, on my rolls and shawarmas. Now I'll also show you a quick salad recipe. So how do I dress my salad with mayonnaise? So I take the chopped vegetables as per your desire. You may take anything that you like. I usually love a lot of greens in my salad, in my sandwiches and wraps. So I'm taking capsicum and onion chopped here, about 1/2 cup each. To it, I'm adding lettuce. You may add cabbage as discussed in my last video. This is a similar video, this is the same video in fact, so I'm just repeating it so that you know you're aware of what salad goes into my sandwiches and my plating. So I am adding lettuce here, about 1/2 cup, and then I would take 1/2 cup of sliced tomatoes. You may add your olives, you may add variety of cucumber, variety of salads, whatever you like. I've just sprinkled a little salt and a little coriander, and then also you may add a little bit of sugar, but because my mayonnaise had sugar, I did not add any sugar to my salad. Now this is my homemade mayonnaise, completely veg, which I'm just adding about 2-2.5 tablespoons. Give it a good mix and then start using it for your amazing plating, that is for your sandwiches. You may just have it with some croutons sprinkled over, or probably some meat if you're a meat eater. So that's how delicious your salad would turn up with the homemade mayo. So this is how I plate it. I just plate it with some toast, some salad, some scrambled egg and fresh watermelon juice. Thank you for watching Prati's Kitchen.